good. All right, from one management to another, let's talk about NIIT Limited, which delivered a decent set of Q3 numbers. Yes, the margins were a bit of a miss, and on account of that, you know, the profits as well were more or less flattish on a year-on-year basis at about 19.5 crore rupees. So let's discuss the numbers then with Mr. Rajendra Pawar. He's the chairman of NIIT Limited. Mr. Pawar, thanks so much for joining in on ET Now. You know, I think dive straight into the internals of what NIIT has done in Q3, apart from, of course, the individual, the broader numbers. If I could first understand in one of your key segments, the corporate learning group, what was the growth like, and also was there any uptick in revenue visibility on TCV of new deal wins and client signing?
So the growth in the corporate learning business has been very healthy again. It's around 25%. And even the visibility has gone up, in fact, much more. It's 28% up to $255 million. So the corporate learning business is clocking at a solid pace with steady margins and few good new accounts also coming in. So I think that business has stabilized at a good level, at a good level of margin, and is clocking very healthy growth. So that business, I would say, is currently about more than two-thirds of the total business. So it's clocking very well.
Okay. So within CLG, within the corporate learning group, which areas exactly are driving traction? How is the pipeline also looking? And if you could just throw some color on, the deal sizes, are they increasing?
We have two significant deals, both in the healthcare sector. Of course, influenced also by the recent acquisition, which is Eagle, which is working in that space. But these are larger deals than what Eagle does. So significant size for very good blue chip clients. So the deal sizes are significant. They're getting bigger as we go. And you already know that we have a very, very good lineup of Fortune 100 clients in our list. So the corporate learning business, as I mentioned, continues to go from strength to strength. Superior clients, a good range of clients, and order intake, the visibility, as I said, is up 28%. So in this business, I would say that we have a very good engine at work, and even qualitatively, we are moving up the chain in terms of the kind of technology we use. So a bit of virtual reality being used in some of the newer projects. So on all fronts, the corporate learning business, which as I mentioned is more than two-thirds, is touching 70% of the business, is clocking very well.
Okay. I know for a fact that you've been focusing on better EBITDA growth as well. So what sort of margin improvement are you aiming across your segments? I know you already mentioned that CLG is doing well on a margin perspective, but if you have to talk about even skills and careers, if you have to talk about Mind Champion, what sort of margin improvement are you looking at over there?
So, well, we are touching a double digit. We obviously want to cross that and go beyond for the overall business. So in the skills business, you know, we are beginning to see that with talent becoming short, which you people also talking about a lot now in the IT sector. So with that, there is a bit of a lag, of course, but we see that there's talent tightness happening in the IT sector now. The hiring this year, we expect in the IT sector to be significantly better than last year. The uptick is there. So the skills business is beginning to benefit from the bit of tightening on the talent pipeline, but there is a bit of a latency. So between the time we bring students in and the time we bring them out, it takes a little time. Now the placements of the skills business are better, the collections are better, the order intake is inching up, and I think that will gradually translate into revenue because there's, as I said, there's a lag in the service delivery from the time we start to the time we finish. So in skills, the outlook is looking better, and that gives us the confidence that we should see that outlook and the better hiring and the somewhat better enrollments, visibly better enrollments, translating into revenue as we go forward. And since the skills business is a largely fixed cost business, there as the revenue builds up, as the occupancy builds up, the translation to the margins is also quite direct. So the outlook for this sector, for this sub sector of our business in skills, is getting better.
Mr. Pawar, I must ask you also about the recent buzz.
They are the ones which are getting.
Okay. Mr. Pawar, I must
I hear the same buzz that you hear and create, so nothing to comment on that.
Let me hazard a guess over here. It's about, of course, NIIT in talks to sell that 23.5% stake in NIIT Tech. So, I'm just going to risk a question over here. Could you confirm, deny any of these reports? I mean, we understand even promoter individuals who are holding 77.5% are interested. So, could you just throw some more light on that?
Well, there's no comment at this time. Every few years we hear the news, and every few years we have to say the same thing. So, no comments.
Well, it's our job, in the media to address all those rumors and help our viewers quash any sort of uncertainties in their minds. But anyway, thank you, Mr. Pawar, for joining in, helping us understand your Q3 numbers, way forward, and of course, even talking
so
about
much.
Those rumors with respect to the promoter stake sale. Okay. Just about testing 10,800 for the Nifty. We will do one thing. We will take a very short break right here on the show. Tirumalai Chemicals. Okay. That's a stock that's hit a 52-week low. The stock price, in fact, was falling. It was locked in the lowest circuit, in fact.